Ho, ho, ho! Good morning and welcome to Cindy's Kitchen Christmas Edition. Yes, it is Christmas Eve, our last Cindy's Kitchen before the big day. Welcome to everyone. We're a cooking community, a fun show on Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Saturday mornings, 11 a.m. Central Standard Time. If you're brand new, welcome. Glad to have you here. Make sure you say hello and tell us where you're from. If you're watching the replay, #replay. Just want to watch an edited version and get the recipe? Head on over to our YouTube channel, also conveniently called Cindy's Kitchen. Good morning and cheers. Hi, Ann and Debbie, Sue and Julie. Good to see you guys. Joanne's here, Lori, Kimberly. Oh, Merry Christmas from Texas to you too. There's a Merry Christmas from Illinois. Katrina's on, Charlene. Debbie, Merry Christmas cold in Chicagoland. Hey, Britt, cheers to you. Oh, Sue, thank you. I appreciate it. Good morning, Janet. Oh, Joanne. Oh, you have morning snow. Aw, oh, Janet. Good morning and Merry Christmas. Good morning, Mom. Hello, Barbara. Merry Christmas. Just you from Pennsylvania. Hey, Julie from Northwest Houston. I loved all your old pictures this morning, Julie. Good morning, Lori. Ah, from Maryland. And happy Christmas Eve in the UK. Troy, oh, good morning. I hope you and your beautiful bride have a very Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas to you too, Joanne. Merry Christmas from More Polish Pottery. Hello, Rebecca. Good to see you. Look, it's Christmas Eve, and I went through all of my mugs, and I wanted to find what would bring me the most joy this morning. And that's what I do every day. I pick out my coffee cup on what brings me joy. Merry Christmas, Gail. Eve from cold 13 degrees Chicago. Look, I know I've used this one before, but does that just not bring you really big joy? Big joy. Big joy. Barbara, it's raining there. We had rain yesterday. Horrible wind. It was 71 degrees, and then poof, this morning, 39. Oh, happy Christmas, Linda Sue. Arati, Merry Christmas. 21 degrees in Michigan. Brr. You have the same one in your cabinet? Okay, we will cheer. Cheer. All right, we got a lot cooking. 9 degrees in Illinois. Brr. Thank you, Debbie. All right, so I'm going to cheer, and then we're going to get started. We have a lot to do in Cindy's Kitchen Christmas Edition today. Cheers. Last sip. Okay. Mrs. Santa Claus has to go. Say bye-bye. Bye-bye, Mrs. Santa Claus. Okay, it is cold in Texas. So today, I know that you're going to be going, what? This is not a Christmas meal. And it's not. But I figure you probably already have your menu set for tomorrow and tonight. So really, to give you ideas for Christmas is just silly. So I decided, if you remember when I was at the store yesterday, that we would do something a little different. Good morning, Angela. So we're starting with a rutabaga, a parsnip, a purple sweet potato, and a carrot. Okay, now these have all been washed. And so here's what we're gonna do. Before you got here, I know, did I do something? Did I cook something without you? Before we're gonna do a drink, Joanne, I promise. Adult beverage. Before you got here, I melted a stick of butter, a whole stick of butter, I tell you. And then I sliced up 3 big mango yellow onions, okay? So let me show you. And for the last 45 minutes on low, this is what I've been doing. Okay, do you see? Onions, See how they're turning that lovely brownish color? And so I'm just gonna let these continue to cook and caramelize. Okay, tell me, who likes French onion soup? Tell me, do you like French onion soup? All right, here we go. You tell me if you like French onion soup. I think if you do, you're really gonna like this. All right, the rutabaga. I'm gonna go ahead and slice off one end just so I have it. My kitchen does smell awesome. Okay, I'm just gonna slice off the end so it'll lay flat. Now, I'm gonna use my vegetable peeler for almost everything we do today, but this'll be a little easier for me and a little faster just to take my knife and run it around the edge. See how I'm doing that? Easy peasy lemon squeezy. So we go all the way around. For me, just a little easier. We're gonna talk about the rutabaga, love French onion, all soups. Oh, and it's your favorite. Well, that's good. It's a good thing, then I think you'll like this. My mother informed me this morning when I talked to her. I talk to my mom every morning on the phone usually. And she informed me this morning when I told her what I was cooking that she has never liked rutabagas. No matter who cooked them, she did not like them. Well, I shall change all that. I vow to change your dislike of the lowly rutabaga. All right, so I got my rutabaga. I am going to peel the outside of my parsnip, okay? So that's what the inside looks like, okay? So I'm just gonna run my vegetable peeler down and remove the outer skin of the parsnip. I'm not doing it to the carrot because it's washed and it's fine. But there we go, parsnip icky. And I'm gonna peel, caramelized onions, I know. Good morning, Jennifer. My purple sweet potato, because how cool is a purple sweet potato? Look at that. Is that the coolest thing ever? So I know that several of you said that you had heard of, seen, used purple sweet potatoes. Not me. I had never even seen a purple sweet potato until yesterday. Well, you guys know of my love of all things purple. And so I'm expanding your palate. It will be fun. We're gonna have a good day. All right, bye-bye skins. In you go. Ta and da. And then we have our carrot. Oh, I have to show you something. You're gonna chuckle. We had to have Christmas last night because Philip is working in the ICU for the next 4 days. Ugh, 14-hour days in the ICU. Ugh. So we were not gonna be able to have Christmas. And I don't know the story about Carl Sandburg and the rutabagas. Katie wants my purple pots and pans, Vonnie cooking show. But there you go. Katie wants my purple and she's getting my old set of pots and pans. You're getting an air fryer and an instant pot. Oh, good for you, Linda. Nothing. Lori, were you naughty? I think you were probably naughty, huh? No, I'm just kidding. The good thing is we have each other. What a great gift, stocking full of coal, Jessica. We have each other, which is great, because, you know, here we go. Even if you're all alone, like, I know that several of you are quarantined or really kind of alone, right? And that being said, several of us, even though we might have family, oh, you asked for a new wallet. That I need, I don't go anywhere, but that might be good. Oh, and I have this garlic. There's like just a little left. Not enough to, you know, to. Electric smoker for outside. A vacation sometime, sir. That would be good, but I don't like the ends. And it's whatever you grew up with. Woo! I got garlic flying. I had veggies flying. Now there's garlic flying everywhere. I'm not even gonna chop it up. I'm just gonna toss it in there. This little sleeve. And you put the garlic in there and then you rub it together and all the skin is supposed to come off. Didn't work. Or I didn't do it right. Oh, the wallet is full. That would be good, wouldn't it? Yeah. Oh, yes, charcuterie boards. Those would be awesome. Healthy family. There you go. But, you know, I'm just grateful I have you guys and Grace. Okay, look at this. Mushrooms, yellow squash, and tomatoes. Well, we need some salt, right? So, but about, you know, I'm not giving you a recipe for this, but anytime you do veggies, you need salt and pepper. I'm just saying. This is gonna be kind of an Italian-y blend. And so I'm gonna put some oregano. Oregano. My oregano was empty, so I had to get a new one. Oh, that is not sprinkly. So all I have to do is heat that up. So then you have to have something to go with it for tonight. And root vegetable, French onion root vegetable, bake in the oven. Our questionable veggies of tomatoes, mushrooms, yellow squash, a couple cloves of garlic, salt, pepper, olive oil, and a little oregano in the oven at 400. Well, it makes it easier. I don't like when people use stuff that I've never heard of. Okay, the only other thing I have to have when everything comes out is I've got some flat leaf parsley. And since we did the whole Italian kind of theme on my questionable veggies, it's got olive oil and garlic and oregano. When it comes out, I'm gonna chop this flat leaf parsley up and then we're gonna put that, and so it'll have a nice fresh taste when it comes out. Okay, you know what?